Tuesday.
And what am I doing posting on YouTube? Let's talk about that. That's good. September 26th and of the year 2023. I recently have just had some changes in heart. When I was younger, I used to post on YouTube all the time. That was when like YouTube was very popularized, but I also just loved making videos. I love editing the videos. It was such a creative thing for me. Like many of my hobbies and interests and creative endeavors, I abandoned it kind of abruptly as well. And since that time when I was younger, I have really learned like the discipline of being consistent with something. Even when in that moment, you don't get the immediate gratification from it. When I was in high school, towards like the second half of high school, I started posting on TikTok and I would make like funny story times of just like funny experiences I've had in my life. And a lot of those started to get a lot of attention and I started to grow a little bit of a following on social media. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is like what I had hoped to accomplish with YouTube, what I always loved doing. I love making videos. But with that too, I was like, well, I don't really want these story time videos to be my niche anymore. Like, I also want to have moments where I get real and like can talk about things that like really matter, or like just the mundane parts of life as well. That's why I was kind of like compelled to kind of move away from story times. Since that time, nothing has ever been as popular as when I would make those story times, except what seems to get a lot of attention as well is like when I make videos about dating or my relationship. I love making TikTok videos, but I don't love making the types of TikTok videos that I know people will like just for the sake of people liking them. It's not worth it to me, but I love creating content, and it was never about other people's seeing it, their reaction to it. I did it because it was fun, it was like a free expression of myself, and I don't want to abandon that part because that is what I still love. As much as I do still post on TikTok and I like posting on TikTok, I don't post like with the intention of like, this is gonna get me a lot of views. And so that's why I was like, I wanna go back to like slow content, like content where I just like don't have to speed it up into 15 seconds. It's not like you're consuming. It's more intentional, it's more present. So that's what made me think maybe I should start posting on YouTube again. So that's why I'm here. So I wanted to show you guys. This is my mom and sister's garden. They compost. Well, we compost as a family. We have two different types. We have a regular compost and a worm compost. And they're right there. That's our regular compost. That's our worm compost. And this is just some of what they've been able to plant. They planted these pretty flowers. And then they have actual foods down here. They have tomatoes. Some of it's not surviving, as you could see. But yeah, that's our garden. I'm at the grocery store. I just had the just crappiest experience because I pull up to the grocery spot that I pull up to the parking lot and I'm looking to park in this spot and I go to pull around like I'm gonna park in it and then I look and there's a whole shopping cart in the middle of the parking spot. So I put my hazards on and I pull my car over and I move the shopping cart out of the way so that I can park my car. But I'm fully intending that as soon as I park, I'm gonna use that shopping cart to go inside and grocery shop. Like I was just moving it because I'm like, nobody's gonna move it. Everybody's gonna pass this parking spot. And so I move the shopping cart and I put it like to this side, to my left side. I didn't know that the lady was in her car and she was trying to leave the grocery store. So then I park my car really quick. I grab the shopping cart and I roll it up like to my door because I still need to like grab my things. And then the lady like shook her head at me. So now I put the cart back entirely and I've just been sitting in my car for like 20 minutes because that made me so sad. I was well intending, I promise. Now I'm about to go in the grocery store. Also, I got ready, I'm wearing these pants. I have my bag and I'm wearing my knockoff Birkenstocks. These are knockoffs of the Bostons. I got them on Amazon for $35. I've had them for a long time. So they're a little beat. Anyways, let's go grocery shop. Okay, I just finished at the grocery store. Usually my total comes out to like exactly 130 or like 131. Today was 150. And I feel like I got less groceries than I usually get because I have some leftover food. Okay, let's get that AC blowing and going. So I'm gonna give a little grocery haul because I'm like, why not? First thing I got is these pumpkin spice cookies. First things first, I got a cucumber. I don't know why this is so big, but this is literally the last one they had. Okay, I'm done holding this cucumber. But I got these Star Puff crackers. They're made from vegetables as well as other things, of course. Ooh, how cute. Look at that little. They're good. They're not as flavorful as I thought they might be. They're pizza flavored, but they're pretty good. I got 4 kombuchas. I got 3 guava goddess ones and 1 trilogy. American cheese and feta cheese. American cheese for the veggie burgers that I'm gonna have, and feta cheese for the chickpea salad I'm gonna make. I got these fig bars. I love these. They have a pumpkin flavor, but I got the apple cinnamon ones this time. Next, I got 2 Chobani vanilla yogurts. Sorry, I feel like the phone is sliding. 7 multi-grain sourdough. Then I got hamburger buns. I got this salsa because we have a lot of tortilla chips at home, and this salsa, like restaurant style salsa, is the best salsa. Then I got this cocoyo pumpkin spice flavor coconut yogurt. It's not really yogurt, it doesn't have dairy, but it's made of coconut and it does have live cultures. Raw young coconut meat, coconut water, pumpkin puree, vanilla extract, clove extract, nutmeg. Then I got some cherry tomatoes because with the sourdough, I'm gonna put cherry tomatoes, pesto, and Parmesan cheese, and then I'm gonna toast them in the oven. The next thing I got teriyaki seaweed. I love seaweed. Oh my god, these are crazy. So first of all, I ate one of these whole bags in a sitting, but this is the snack pack with 5 bags inside, so I got 2. This is the best beef jerky. I don't even like mess with beef jerky like that. I didn't eat meat for a pretty long time, and so now that I'm reintroducing meat and trying to be more protein sufficient, I started eating some beef jerky, and this was in my house, and oh my gosh, this is the best beef jerky I've ever eaten. So I find this very tolerable to eat, and it's seasoned very well. Garbanzo beans. The clerk at the store was really excited to tell me that these were 2 for $3, so I got 2 of them. Tomato for the chickpea salad and for our burgers. Then I got pesto. This is just some organic Tuscan basil pesto. And I got bananas, and then I got black bean quinoa burgers. And that is everything that I got. Honestly, a pretty terrific haul. I didn't show you guys, but this is the front herb garden. This one is very fruitful. We've got lots of cool stuff up here. But yeah.